Hello everyone, it's me, Jan Misali, the guy who makes the show Conlang Critic. I also made a video about math that's somehow more popular than anything else I've ever made. If you haven't seen that video, go watch it before watching this, because this video won't make any sense otherwise. Actually, go watch A Better Way to Count anyway. It's a pretty good video. Okay, so what even is the deal with that video? I mean, was I being serious or was I joking? Why weren't bases besides seximal, decimal, and decinal analyzed? And why do I talk so fast? First of all, at the risk of stating the obvious, A Better Way to Count is, in fact, a serious educational video that just happens to have jokes in it. The source of the confusion is almost certainly the way I handled the intro. See, I wanted to explain why I don't like decimal by doing an intentionally bad job of arguing in favor of decimal. I kinda assumed that the viewer would have a certain level of familiarity with decimalism going in, meaning that they'd be able to catch on to what I was doing early on and realize that I was making fun of decimalism. The one joke in this part I got the most comments about was where I said that 10 has two prime factors and that 12 has 6 factors. Obviously, that's not actually a fair comparison. It's so obviously not a fair comparison that I was foolishly certain that anyone who paid attention and noticed that I did that would immediately realize that I must be joking. How silly of me. One other thing I feel like I should address before we get into the meat of this video is the name I used for base 6. I personally like to call base 6 seximal. Now, from what I've been told through various YouTube comments, some of you are unable to take the name seximal seriously. I honestly can't imagine why. Sure, it's non-standard, but alternative bases are already non-standard to begin with. The standard name for base 6, specifically the one used by Wikipedia, is senary. But I don't like that name very much because it doesn't sound like any other Latin-derived words in English that have to do with the number 6, and it also doesn't really sound like a number base. The name seximal fixes both of these problems. A much less vocal group of people, by the way, have complained about the name dozenal for base 12. The name dozenal is very commonly used by people who advocate for the use of base 12, including the Dozenal Society of America. Calling it dozenal instead of duodecimal is meant to avoid any decimal centrism. After all, Latin uses decimal, and if you're in favor of using some other base, deriving terminology directly from Latin sort of goes against what you're after. Anyway, as promised, here are some replies to the actually good counterpoints I've gotten. Hey, wouldn't seximal break the metric system? Yes, it would. The metric system, which is used almost everywhere in the world, absolutely would not work in any base other than decimal. I mean, sure, you could keep using it, but it isn't nearly as useful for, say, a centimeter to be 1/100th of a meter when the number 100 is actually 2nf4z4. Now, while this problem wouldn't exist for American units, since they don't make sense in decimal to begin with, that doesn't mean that by promoting seximal I'm somehow also promoting the use of the American units. I mean, yes, as an American, that is the system I personally use, so I am at least somewhat biased, but I do understand that this really would cause serious problems for the entire rest of the world. The proper solution to this, naturally, is to create a completely new system of measurement to go along with the seximal system. I made a half-serious proposal at one point with base units derived from metric imperial compromises, like how the unit of length is a stick, defined as the average between a meter and a yard. The exact base units in a measurement system aren't actually all that important. What matters is how the units are related to each other. All you really need to make a seximal measurement system is a set of power of 6 prefixes. Once you have those, you can just apply them to whatever existing units you want to create a fully functional seximal measurement system. Yes, theoretically it would be very difficult, almost impossible even, to get everyone to switch what measurements they use, but not actually any more impossible than getting everyone to switch numbering systems in the first place. Fun fact, 1/9th of a meter, which using the prefixes I came up with would be called a nifty meter, is actually really, really close to an American inch. Makes you think. Another fun fact, let's say you want to use degrees Celsius in seximal. Obviously, that would be inconvenient because the boiling point of water would no longer be a convenient round number, right? Well, get this. NIF degrees Celsius is equal to 2/4z and 4/5 of a degree Fahrenheit, which in decimal is exactly 96.8, meaning that a 0 to NIF scale in Celsius works as a scale from the freezing point of water to human body temperature. Wait, why exactly are fourths less important than fifths? That wasn't made clear. Also, you should say quarters, it's more proper. Yep, fair enough. So yes, fourths are more practical than fifths, being a simpler fraction. There are, in fact, more situations where you need to use fourths than there are situations where you need to use fifths. Having a single-digit representation of fourths, however, is not as important. That's because a fourth is half of a half. If you're using an even base, you're guaranteed to have single-digit halves, which makes it pretty easy to divide any given number by 2. In turn, that means that even if you, for some reason, can't be bothered to remember how to write a fourth, it's pretty trivial to derive it from scratch. Fifths, on the other hand, can be very difficult to derive. 5 is a prime number, so if a base doesn't have a simple representation for fifths, you're basically out of luck. That's the case in dozenal. As I'm sure you recall, fifths are represented by 4 recurring digits, which essentially means you just can't use fifths in any useful way. Sure, maybe they don't come up as often as fourths, but dozenal doesn't even give you the option. It's important to remember, by the way, that the way a base handles simple ratios isn't just about the ratios themselves. While that is what I generally focus on because it's easy to demonstrate, an integer whose reciprocal is handled in a simple way in any given base is an integer that base considers to be important. This matters for all sorts of things, including division, factorization, and patterns in multiplication tables. Here's one situation you might care about. How can you tell if a number is prime? As we all know, a prime number is a number with no factors other than 1 in itself. Let's say you want to know if a number is prime quickly, just by looking at it, no complicated division required. Specifically, you want a system you can do in your head that rules out numbers that are clearly not prime. In other words, what numbers look prime? In decimal, you can easily tell if a number is even and if a number is divisible by 5 by looking at the last digit. So 12 doesn't look like a prime number, and neither does 15. You can also add digits together and see what factors a number has in common with 9, which for small numbers, you can easily do in your head. 21 doesn't look prime, and neither does 27. You can also recognize small factors of 11 pretty easily because they're two-digit numbers where both digits are the same. 77 doesn't look like a prime number. Using these simple methods to see what numbers look prime in decimal, the smallest number that looks prime but isn't really is 49. Of course, there's a good chance you might just recognize this number as being 7 squared, but if you don't already know that, there's no easy way of figuring that out just by looking at it. It ends with 9, so it isn't even, and it's not divisible by 5. 4 plus 9 is 13, and 1 plus 3 is 4, so it's not divisible by 3 either. It's clearly not a multiple of 11, and that's all the easy divisibility tests you can do in your head. What numbers look prime in seximal? Well, if you look at a list of primes in seximal, you'll notice one very clear pattern. Yes, after 2 and 3, the two factors of 6, every single prime number ends with either 1 or 5. This is because numbers that end with any other digit in seximal are guaranteed to be even and or divisible by 3. This isn't to say that every number that ends with 1 or 5 in seximal is automatically prime, far from it. However, this quick test automatically prevents even and 3-ven numbers from looking like primes. The other simple test you can do rule out a good portion of the remaining composite numbers that just happen to not be even or 3-ven. Remember, you can do different digit sum tests in seximal to see if a number is divisible by 5 and or 7. The biggest number that looks prime in seximal but isn't really prime is 3NF-dozen-1. It ends with 1, so it's not even or 3-ven. 3 plus 2 plus 1 is 6, so it's not divisible by 5, and 3 plus dozen-1 is dozen-4, so it's not divisible by 7. The number 3NF-dozen-1 is, in fact, equal to 11 squared. It's 121 in decimal. Every number smaller than it can be easily identified as either prime or composite completely accurately with nothing but basic mental math. Let's skip to the punchline. What's the smallest composite number that looks prime in dozenal? Well, it's actually 2 dozen 1. It ends with 1, so it's not even, and it's not divisible by 3. 2 plus 1 is 3, so it's not divisible by 11, and it's very clearly not divisible by dozen 1. This number, of course, is actually equal to 5 squared. 2 dozen 1 equals 25 in decimal. Again, if you have your multiplication tables properly memorized, you could just recognize this number and its factors, but if you don't, you're out of luck. What is that thing you were saying about base NIF? That sounds interesting, and you should have actually talked about it in the video instead of offhandedly mentioning it in that way too fast voice you're constantly doing. Base NIF, or NIFTIMAL as I like to call it, is a rather elegant solution to the most obvious problem with using seximal. 6 is a really small number, so numbers in base 6 can get pretty long. Sure, if you take into account how much information is contained in each digit, those longer numbers are technically more efficient than decimal, but that doesn't make them take up any less physical space on a page. The easiest way to compress numerical information in any given base is to use a larger set of symbols that correspond to 2 digits each. In other words, use the base's square. For large bases, this isn't really a viable option. Compressing decimal this way would require a system with 100 distinct digits, which is, let's be honest, too many to keep track of. Sure, it's possible, but it would certainly be more trouble than it's worth. Fortunately, since 6 isn't a very big number, neither is its square. NIF, decimal 36, is a pretty reasonable amount of digits. In fact, there's one really nice coincidence when it comes to selecting which NIF digits to use. See, as I'm sure you know, the most common way to extend the Hindu-Arabic numeral system is using the letters of the Latin alphabet. The Latin alphabet has exactly 2 baker's dozen letters. That's seximal 4z2 and decimal 26. Those of you who are good at addition are sure to notice that that's precisely the amount you need to add to the 10 Hindu Arabic digits to end up with nif digits. Using niftimal allows you to make any given number in seximal take up half the space it otherwise would. I would like to stress that while this is a useful system for compressing seximal information, I am not advocating for using niftimal exclusively. While nif isn't an inconveniently large number of digits, it's absolutely too many to be used for basic arithmetic. In my opinion, the limit for how large a base can get while still being human usable is somewhere between thirsy and forsy. When using base nif, in order to reduce the mental strain, it's best to convert numbers into seximal before doing math to them, and then to convert back into niftimal when you're done. I'll admit that this isn't a perfect solution, but it does work. Okay, but how good is base? Sure, let's do a quick rundown of various bases and how good I think they are. Remember, the things that matter when comparing a base to other bases are the number of digits it has and how the base writes simple ratios. The number of digits a base has determines how efficiently it stores numerical information, and the way a base writes simple ratios determines what numbers that base has an easy time handling in general. This focus on how ratios are handled completely rules out things like non-integer bases and unary. Again, this is a quick rundown and not a comprehensive overview. Anyway, let's start with base 2, binary. Binary is the smallest base that actually works at all. Doing simple arithmetic in binary is super easy, and only having two digits means storing binary information on a computer is maximally efficient. That's about it for positives. Every other aspect of binary is a downside. Numbers get real long real fast, and the only terminating ratios are the ones where the denominator is a power of 2. Oh, by the way, the ratios I'm showing in red here are the ones that are as complex as they hypothetically could be. You know, the really bad ones. And yes, I'm using underlines instead of overlines for recurring digits. Base 3, trinary. Trinary is a lot like binary. It's a small prime base, so it's easy to do math at the cost of everything taking a lot of digits to write. It is a bit better at some ratios than binary, but at the cost of halves, which, let's be honest, are absolutely vital. Now, I should probably mention one specific version of trinary that's usually called balanced ternary. Balanced ternary is just like normal trinary, except instead of its three digits being 0, 1, and 2, its three digits are negative 1, 0, and 1. I'm not gonna get into exactly how it works, but I will say that it is cool and interesting, and that you should absolutely go look it up if you haven't heard of it before. However, it is still just base 3 at a fundamental level, so in terms of actual practicality, it's not really that much of an improvement. Base 4, quaternary. Now, quaternary is where things start to get interesting. Remember, square bases can be used for compression, and quaternary is the smallest square base. It's really just a more efficient version of binary. It's still pretty small, and it can't really handle any non-power of 2 denominators, but other than that, it's pretty solid. Base 5, quinary. Quinary is a prime base and a great example of why prime bases aren't great. We'll see a few more of these later. A prime number is the exact opposite of what makes a good base. Base 6, seximal. I think I've made my thoughts on this one clear enough. Base 7, septimal. Prime base number 4. This is the smallest regular base Wikipedia doesn't have a dedicated article about. 7 is just a really inconvenient number. Base 8, octal. Octal is another power of 2 base, 8 being 2 cubed. Just like how one digit in quaternary corresponds to 2 binary digits, one digit in octal corresponds to 3 binary digits. This is actually a pretty popular choice for a compressed binary method, mainly because it's pretty close in size to decimal. Unfortunately, when it comes to representing simple ratios, groups of 3 binary digits don't always quite work out, so there's a lot of ratios where octal isn't any better off than binary. Base 9, nonary. Nonary is probably the most usable odd base. Pretty much entirely because 9 is equal to 3 squared. Its convenient ratios almost make up for how it can't do halves. Almost. Like, if you're gonna fail at one ratio, halves are the worst one to fail at. Base 10, decimal. I trust you know about this one already. Base 11, elevenary. Also known as undecimal, elevenary is prime base number 5. It's sometimes suggested as a joke. Since 11 is right between 10 and 12, it works great as a compromise between decimal and dozenal. Oh, speaking of, base 12, dozenal. You know, this one. Let's, skip ahead a ways. Base dozen 4, hex. Of all the bases I didn't talk about in a better way to count, hex was the one I got the most comments about. Hex is extremely popular among computer scientists as a way of compressing binary. Base dozen 4, that's decimal 16, is a square base, so one hex digit corresponds to 2 quaternary digits. As I'm sure you remember, one quaternary digit corresponds to 2 binary digits, meaning that one hex digit corresponds to 4 binary digits. Needless to say, hex is extremely good at compressing binary. The main drawback for hex is that, like every power of 2 base, the only terminating ratios are the ones where the denominator is a power of 2. Also, with its dozen 4 digits, hex is close to the edge of the human usable range of bases. It's pretty big. Also, the fact that hex is so popular is the literal only thing stopping me from referring to base 6 as hexamal. Base dozen 5, suboptimal. Of all the integer bases in the human usable range, this is the worst one. That's why it's called suboptimal, because it's so bad. If you want to suggest using a base as a joke, this is the base for you. Base 32, VIGESIMAL. That's decimal 20. VIGESIMAL is the largest base in the human usable range that's actually used by anyone. If you go much further, things get pretty hard to handle. As for VIGESIMAL itself, well, it's somewhat of a mixed bag in terms of practicality. Look, it's got single-digit fourths and fifths. Plus, its sevenths are just two recurring digits for some reason. This is, however, at the cost of thirds. For a base this size, not being able to handle thirds in a convenient way is sort of a deal-breaker. Now, I'm here saying that this is close to the edge of the human usable range, but as many of you have surely noticed, there's something I seem to have ignored. See, there's this one numbering system that was used by the ancient Sumerians and the ancient Babylonians that's had a pretty major impact on how certain things are counted. Base Nif-Forzi, base 5-dozen, base 60, base Tenzi, sexagesimal, as it's commonly called. Now, tenzi is quite a few digits. I'd argue that it's too many to be practical. So then, how on earth did those ancient cultures who used this base actually manage it? Well, as it turns out, they kinda cheated. Sexagesimal, as it was used in ancient Mesopotamia, really only used two digits. See, there was one narrow wedge shape for one, and another wider wedge shape for 10. These wedges were grouped in a way that looks somewhat like a decimal upgrade of tally marks. The key difference was that these groupings were then used as digits themselves. For example, a number like 22, 60s, and 7 would indeed be written with two digits, but those digits would be made up of one grouping of two 10 wedges and two 1 wedges, and then another grouping of 7 1 wedges. We could transcribe this with our Hindu-Arabic numerals as 2207, maybe with something separating the two sexagesimal digits. This method, where each digit is written with some combination of symbols instead of one single symbol, is what makes it possible to actually use these bases that are too large to be used normally. If you can get over the hurdle of one more layer of complexity, these larger bases have a lot of potential, but that's a topic for another time. You know, in the grand scheme of things, it doesn't actually matter what base we use. The benefits any given base has are completely outweighed by the problems that would be caused by switching what base we as a society use in the first place. Yup, none of this matters. I do not recommend or expect anyone to completely stop using decimal. That would be very silly. Despite that, it's fun to get silly sometimes. At a fundamental level, if you strip away all this discussion of radix economy and recurring expansions, I like seximal for the same reason dozenalists like dozenal. It's fun to examine how we could theoretically change the things we take for granted, even if we know it could never actually happen. If I haven't been able to convince you that seximal is the best base out there, that's fine. If you strongly disagree with me about this, that's even better. I encourage everyone to develop their own opinions about which numbering system is the best. After all, that's what really counts. Thanks for watching. I've been Jan Misali before, and one day I will be Jan Misali again. Sure, that'll work as a sign-off for non-conlang videos.